The heroes of the Marvel Universe are trapped behind enemy lines, and they're going to need to go to extreme measures if they ever want to fight back against Malekith. All this and more in the pages of War of Realms, issue number 4. Let's hop on in together and find out what happens next, shall we? So, picking up from where the last issue left off, Queen Freya and her team of Avengers had managed to capture Malekith's Black Bifrost that he was using to transport his troops all over the known world. Now that the good guys have it, they can use it to move around their troops, and the Punisher has come to the world of the Elves to try and recruit as many as he can to come to Midgard to help the war effort. Naturally, the elves don't trust him at first. What with the whole grim demeanor and skull on his chest, he almost certainly looks like one of the bad guys, and in fact, the whole issue is filled with different Avengers going to recruit different magical creatures. We got elves and dwarves and Vanir gods, giant spiders from hell, we got all the warriors, I tell you, all the warriors. The only problem is holding on to the Black Bifrost, particularly the sword that runs the whole thing, Bitter End is causing Freya to lose her mind to a deep, dark corruption. Doesn't stop her, though, from killing dark elves by the hundreds, though she's certain that this is her mission and that if she's the captain, she's gonna go down with this ship, keeping it open as long as humanly possible. And admittedly, this is the first bit of good news the heroes have had for a long time. Captain America and his team are able to spirit Thor back to Avengers Mountain, which is coming under attack. Luckily, Black Panther, with the help of his sister Shuri, is able to hack the ancient celestial weaponry of their new base of operation and turn it against the bad guys. Now, once Odin hears about what's going down with his wife, he pulls himself out of bed, despite the fact that after the original assassination attempt on his life and leading the Valkyries to Earth, the Allfather ain't doing so hot. He vows to bring Queen Freya back even if it kills him, and Tony figures that if he's going to fight the good fight, he better have a really good weapon to do so. And thus we are introduced to the Allfather armor, built by designs from Tony Stark, crafted by dwarven hands, and programmed by Wakandans. It's an absolute wrecking ball of a suit, and with it, Odin is able to come and try and rescue Freya. Of course, she doesn't want to leave, even if she wasn't being corrupted at the moment. And it's right here in the blood and mud of battle, King and Queen decide to actually work out a bunch of their different issues that have been building up pretty much since the beginning of Jason Aaron's Thor run. They fight hard and they fight fast, and in the end they kill more Dark Elves in a single day than anyone ever has before them, before eventually succumbing themselves to the Horde. The King and Queen may have died, but their memories will most certainly live on. Even the Punisher gets a darkly humorous line into Thor saying, "Hey, sorry about your family, and sorry about your arm, but here's one from the Destroyer armor." The God of Thunder then thanks Jane, the new All-Mother, and the Avengers for everything they've done in helping to fight his war, but he knows full well that this is his battle to finish, and that everyone else is gonna have to get in line behind Thor for what's about to happen next. And so that was War of Realms issue number 4, everybody, and I gotta say, this series is starting to heat up all over again. It was nice to see Freya and Odin work through their issues, even if it was possibly the last thing they've done. Killing the King and Queen, if that is indeed what they've done here, will certainly shake up the power balance of the Thor book, assumedly after Jason Aaron leaves, and could lead to some interesting ideas for some new writers. There's also a really unexpected C-plot running through the War of Realms story as it relates to Venom the symbiote, and how Malekith is aware about Null the God of Symbiotes, and how he wants to turn the black suit into a weapon again as it was always meant to be. I guess that's just how popular Venom is as a character again, and how much Marvel really wants to push him moving forward. I just really didn't think I would see it in a War of Realms story. Overall, I did enjoy this issue, even if I still cannot help but shake the feeling that the pacing here feels strange for whatever reason. I can't quite put my finger on it. Ultimately, I'd give this a 7.5.
Hey there, everyone. It's your old pal, Cape Joel, and I want to thank you so much for watching to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, why not check out some of these other videos I have available from the channel? Then you can follow me on Twitter and Facebook at Cape Joel, so you're always up to speed on what I'm doing next. And hey, if you're in the market for some comic book trades of your own, might I recommend using my book depository link down in the description? Not only will you get an amazing deal by not having to pay any shipping and handling, but everything you buy via my specific link actually goes to support me and the channel. So you win, I win, everybody wins, right? What's not to love? And until next time, everyone, this has been Cape Joel, and I will be back again with more comic content that smacks of greatness. Bye-bye, everyone.